Hello, I'm Reporter Newbuddy. A couple of weeks ago, a friend of mine gave me this link for an S&P server. And I got on it, thinking that it would be a server full of fun, adventures, and relaxing times. But what I discovered was something darker. I discovered stories, news that needed to be told. And so I'm taking it upon myself to tell these stories, starting with the first one. I will be delving up into the animal cruelty that goes around this server. What you see follows is an interview that I had with one of the members of the server, Mariah, and then later, Turtle, the actual owner of this server. So, take notice. What you might see might change your perspective. In this episode of UTS News, Seeking the Truth. Hello, I'm here for the interview.
Okay. Follow me.
Okay. Will you please explain to the camera where you're taking me and why?
So I'm going to take you to Cyborg's house because I don't think he treats his animals very well.
Okay.
I'll show you.
We can keep walking while I ask you a few questions.
Okay.
Do you see this a lot? This, like, a lot of animal cruelty?
In a few places, yes.
Keep on following you. Hello. Okay. Have you ever done anything, like, cruel animal cruelty?
I don't think I have.
Okay.
It's hard to get resources in survival, so...
Right. Like, starting off, you did things that you weren't proud of.
Yeah. Don't we all?
Make a note of that. I know you own a shop on here, so can you tell me what, like, the shop is? Are we going in here?
It's a turtle helmet shop.
Okay. Can you tell me how you get these helmets? Or these shells for the helmets?
All you do is you breed the turtles. And then you make baby turtles. And then as soon as the baby turtles are grown up, they grow out of their baby shells. And you use their baby shells to make the helmet.
Okay, so it's more of just like a natural like process that the animals have to go through.
Right.
Okay. So do you want to tell me where we're at and why you brought me here?
So right now we are at Cyborg's area, mm-hmm. And we're here to show you, I'm going to show you how he treats his animals.
Okay. So do you want to tell me what kind of animals I should be expecting?
Llamas, pigs, sheep, cows. You think that animals should always have sunlight, right?
Right?
Right. And they need fresh air, right? Okay.
Oh, that's a lot of turtles trying to get out.
Yep. So that's the one thing. So look at all those poor, defenseless, cute turtles.
Okay.
Clearly they don't like that.
Yeah. There also seems to be turtles getting in, which is weird. Also
maybe trying to help them?
Maybe trying to help escape, yeah. I think the amount of turtles that there are and the amount of cage aren't to scale, so I think this cage will need to be extended. But continue.
Okay. So if you come up here, I mean, his llamas are okay because they're outside. It's in a big area. They have grass. It seems pretty good, right?
I do. Hold on, I do need to pinpoint that there is a skeleton horse within all these llamas.
Yeah, but the horse seems to be fine also.
The horse is one with the llamas. So
we have to see if that horse is getting enough food, but
I just hope these llamas aren't like. I just hope these llamas aren't, you know.
Happy.
No, I hope that they're not like too hot in those sweaters because it's always like really, really hot.
Oh, I haven't seen this barn.
Wow.
Come on, it's
like. This is. Wait, a setup.
Oh, you got some news.
Now, there are a lot of good things with this. Like, there is a good substitute for sunlight, and there's plenty of grass. The problem is that some cages are getting overfull, while other cages aren't. So, there is a huge problem.
Okay, what is so that? Follow me.
That's new. Okay.
Okay.
There is one pet right here.
Oh. Cornelius
the cactus.
Oh, that seems fine.
But he needs water and air.
It's a cactus.
And sunlight.
Okay.
Look!
No, I see it. It says Cornelius the cacti. Cacti is plural cactus, meaning that there are multiple cacti named Cornelius. So where are the others? I see it now. It's a scam. Okay, thank you for pointing it out.
But I put the sign down.
Wait, where's Tucker's place?
Hey, did you put the sign wrong?
That is not Tucker's place.
Hey,
where's Tucker and
hey, Mariah, do you know this way? Hey, Mariah, do you know who did the signs? Mariah, this way. Mariah,
no.
Do you know who did the signs? Because I know who did the signs.
Oh, wow.
What?
You have a. This is juicy for you.
What?
Oh, there are so many wrong things here.
Ooh.
Oh, get your...
Mariah, what are you doing? I've got my camera locked and loaded.
Okay, get ready.
I've heard of scoot. Okay.
Look at right here.
Is
a
that...
A polar bear.
A polar bear in this climate?
In a boat. It also in a boat.
In a
Look
boat?
Look at it. It wants to be free.
Snowmen aren't really considered animals, but this isn't considered safe.
And look, they shaved its head off.
What?
He has an ugly face. He wanted to wear the pumpkin.
Okay, don't ruin its face. Or don't make fun of its face.
Wilson, you're cute on the inside.
Oh, but they kept this snowman's head on?
Hold on. I bet you that's not it. Oh, look at this.
What? Where are you?
Oh! Look at all these chickens!
Look at all them chickens!
Oh no, I'm picking up all the eggs. No, they're my eggs now. They're gonna just.
Dusty!
Wow.
Their babies need to go. Look at Roxy just sitting here.
This is a lot of chickens. It's. Wow.
I am curious. I did give Kat a brown llama. I would love to know where that went.
Look at their turtles! Their sanctuary is like... Oh, you poor thing, why are you... Charles, why are you in a boat?
Guys, I found their animals.
Oh, no, you... Oh!
Oh, my God.
What?
This is dangerous. They've just got lit torches next to the animals. The fur can catch on fire. Also, there's no way to get back up, and I don't know what to do about that.
Oh, I see the way up.
Oh, okay. Look at these cows. There's too many of them.
Well,
and they're
the possible dead llama is possible now. There it is.
Okay. Yeah, but still, that's not good.
Adams, Dawson, and this is just animal abuse at its finest.
Yeah.
You wouldn't believe what you see up here. Look at this llama just tied up.
Oh my god. I haven't seen these owners on in days. This llama's been tied up with nothing but the sink to drink from.
Oh, this is awful.
Look at the next. It's next to a booger. It's a killing good.
And I don't. You might have to sue them.
I don't really have that since it's not my animals, but I can definitely take them to court for animal abuse. Get their animals taken away. You see, this is the stuff that I want to do. I want to change the world with my reports. And showing these horrendous owners, I think can finally expose them and make the world better for animal
owners. Here! Write on my notice.
I will. Alright, I said I've seen what you've done here and it's not good. I'd like an interview. Report on me, buddy.
Hey,
right here. Come here, I'll show you Tucker's house.
Wait, what's this?
Tucker's house?
No! I'm sorry. We didn't even see if there's any animals here.
Oh. There have to be more tortured animals right now.
There are two chickens here underground. What are they supposed to
do? On dead coral!
Oh my god, I thought this was cobbles. This is not safe for chickens.
Dead tube.
The door was open, right? Was the
door
open? Yes.
No, it wasn't. I opened it.
Wow, leaving the door open. Okay, still. That's for that being the only protection that these chickens have from just going out into the ocean. Even if they escape, the chickens don't know how to handle this area. This is just a very dangerous place for chickens.
There you go. If you want to leave your notice. I've seen what you've done here. It's not good. I like an interview report.
There we go.
Important. Point three.
Fine.
So Tucker, you're in big trouble.
Mm-hmm. Tucker.
Here you go.
So is your group.
Tucker, I'm currently recording a video because that's something I do now.
Yeah, right.
I'm recording an interview, and you're one of the prime people in my interview.
Am I gonna get
it? Don't move.
Thank you.
Give me my 16 eggs.
I'm giving you everything,
Tucker. After these two brought me to your place, I didn't expect it to be as bad as it was, but the amount of animal cruelty that goes around in this area alone is outstanding. Come back here. You can't hide from the truth.
I can't because I'm too slow.
Come back here.
Okay, Tucker.
If I ignored the chickens, which I won't, there are still way more that you should know about, and you should have helped stop. I'm gonna steal this.
It's our farm. We need food. I can't open my own door.
You gotta go.
Your farm with the interview.
It has very little water. It's not very well lit in safe ways. You just have lit torches next to the animals, which I've seen a couple of burn marks on those cows.
It's lit.
Please remain serious. Animals are under, again, pressures of glass with just normal windows and normal glass, and which I don't think can withstand that amount of pressure.
Just take what? That.
You didn't even give me anything. You just said take that and then didn't give me anything.
Hold on, my controls are all wonky. Hold on real quick.
You're trying to bribe me with a cookie Mariah made.
I am not.
He didn't even make it.
Look at, I don't even want to talk about there. The polar bear that's stuck in a boat and should not be in this climate. I want to... is there any other animal crimes I should know about?
I don't know. I don't honestly know. Yes, talk to Mariah about her turtle enclosure. It's so small with all those turtles.
Mariah? I thought you said you only had a few turtles, Mariah.
Wait, where'd the turtles go?
Mariah, how many turtles do you have? Well, wasn't that a cliffhanger? Yes. So, as you can tell, this one's a two-parter, where I'll continue it next time interviewing Mariah more deeply about how she deals with animals. And stay tuned for more things. Now, I'm going to leave you guys off with a little clip that was done pre-recording, where things kind of got a little crazy, and Turtle ended up trapping Mariah and killing her. If you see now, oh no, it doesn't have any more. That's fun. No, it's never fun. But yes, so here's a little clip of Mariah dying. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and enjoy this next one. This is Newbuddy signing off. Tell my family I love them. They don't know if it's because of personality or competition, but it is an issue. By donating all of your diamonds a day, you can help prevent the senseless slaughter of Mariah's, and you can maybe save a soul if Mariah had one.